Hello everybody, hello and a warm welcome to the Life Positive show. So our guest for today is Mr. Sandeep Pandit, who will be holding a workshop on self-mastery through mindfulness on 5th September on the online retreat called From the Lockdown to Breakthrough Weekend, organized by the Life Positive Foundation. About Mr. Pandit, he is a certified mindfulness, emotional intelligence and executive leadership coach who has trained under John Malone, who's the former coach to Steve Jobs, and he is the founder of the organization called Soul in Harmony. In the workshop, Sandeep will share secrets to methodically practice mindfulness.
Yes, thank you.
Which will help you discover your true self and carve a resilient mental attitude leading to a super productive work technique. So let's begin our talk for tonight. Today, Mr. Pandit, it's a great joy to have you on the Life Positive show, and it's going to be an honor to have you facilitate that workshop for our viewers and the readers of Life Positive. So to begin with, we would like you to shed some light on what you intend to teach in that workshop and what do you mean by self-mastery. When you say self-mastery to mindfulness, so what is it that you have on your mind when you talk about this particular subject?
Thank you, Shiviji. First of all, I would like to thank you and the entire Life Positive team to have given me this opportunity to reach out to the larger audience, And first of all, you know, what we want to spread to the humanity is that people are waking up with fear, with grief, with a lot of, you know, unhappiness in today's distracted world. And that is where we want to bring in that hope, that love, that gratitude, that appreciation in people's lives, so that they tap in into that massive force, a massive power that they have within themselves. They reach out to that, become what their real core is. So in a nutshell, what we are actually trying to, we'll try to achieve in the workshop on 5th of September, 9:30 to 12:30 is my session. What we'll try to achieve is basically give you, we will give you certain ideas, methods, formula, how you can reach out to your inner core. You can understand your core values. You can understand and decipher your bitter and good experiences, and you can dig out your key strengths. Once you do these three things, you're actually understood who you really are. And once you understand who you really are, understanding leads to mastery. So when you have the data, you have the information of who you really are, then you can work on that and you can master yourself. So basically, as you said, you know, we'll help you discover your true self. And then we will also help you, let me just tell you, we will help you get rid of the past regrets and anxiousness of the future. We'll also help you carve a resilient mental attitude, which will make you super productive. And there are certain methods, and I would not call it hacks, but methods and formulas that I'll be actually sharing it with you. And there is a 6 steps formula. That's why we call it self-mastery code. The program that I'm having, global program that I'm having, is actually self-mastery code, which is a 6 steps formula, which starts from self-awareness and ends at unplug and unleash and become the real true version of what you were meant to be. So that's, yeah.
Amazing, amazing. I do hope that whoever attends your workshop gets a grip on him or herself and his life, because self-mastery is something which we all want to achieve, but we find it very difficult. We want to do something, we end up procrastinating, or we get plagued by fear or doubt. And these things often come in the way of achieving our dreams. And if there are certain tools which can help us eliminate all these blockages from our paths to enable us to reach that particular destination which we so badly want, I think there can be nothing better than that. And I think it's a great opportunity to all the viewers of this show to kind of, you know, not let go of it and make the best out of this opportunity to actually create the life of their dreams. But at the same time, you also say, Mr. Pandit, that you are talking about self-mastery through mindfulness. Now, what is mindfulness according to you, and how would you get, yes, combine these two elements of human life?
You know, we have all heard about personal mastery, self-mastery from the space of, from the point of view and the perspective of success, achievement, performance. Now, that creates a kind of a rat race, and that kind that creates a kind of unnecessary excitement, which is not required. So here is this program, Self-Mastery Code, where I'm actually calling it a consciousness-based self-leadership mantra. So there is a consciousness involved, which in this self-mastery formula that I'm talking about, and we are actually aligning body, mind, heart, and soul. And when we are actually trying to align all this body, mind, heart, and soul together, so we have to start with a foundation. And to me, I will tell you about, I'll share with you more insights about how my journey led me to where I am and what I'm doing today. But self-awareness became the key factor where it actually shifted my life. It actually moved me into a different orbit. And I was trying and doing many things. I was trying to talk and interact with a lot of coaches, mentors. I was following Dr. Wayne Dyer. But, you know, all those things were fragmented and scattered. And I can very well understand a lot of our viewers today would be in that space where they're trying to get an answer to life, but they're somehow they're not able to piece it together. And that is where self, I'm a Vipassana meditator also. When I actually did Vipassana, and then I actually did mindfulness certified training in Europe, actually everything came together and I started to see, life, the real life, the true life, which was meant to me, unfold right in front of me. And the beauty of it was that I was not having that resistance. I gave up that resistance because I was actually hopping from job to job in my 16 years of corporate world. And I was trying to pinpoint on this job is not good for me, this boss is not good for me, or this workspace is not good, environment is not good, all that. But ultimately I understood that there is something that I need to connect back to my core values, which I had actually created during my childhood days. And there was certain incident during my childhood days, which actually gave me a kind of lighthouse. It was like a lighthouse for me. When I actually looked at it, I connected back with those events and opportunity and those anecdotes. And then I actually started understanding that this self-awareness is something that can actually shift lives.
So Sandeep ji, thoda sa aap hame thoda sa glimpse denge ki wo kya cheeze thi jo bachpan ki jisne aapko wo self-awareness ke जोन में लाके रखा, जिसने आपकी लाइफ पे एक लाइट हाउस की तरह काम किया। थोड़ा सा आप एग्जांपल्स देंगे हमारे सुनने वालों को?
जरूर।
कुछ बताएं।
मैं फिफ्थ ग्रेड में था, आई वाज 10 इयर्स ओल्ड, और एंड मैं अचानक से स्पीच डिसऑर्डर आ गया, मतलब मेरे अंदर आई हैड द स्पीच डिसऑर्डर। उसकी वजह से क्या हुआ, आई स्टार्टेड स्टैमरिंग, स्टटरिंग, and I used to hide behind heads. When teacher used to stand up and ask to read the chapter aloud, I used to hide behind heads. And every day, every moment, every hour, every period was agonizing for me, because I was waiting and praying that, you know, my chance should not come. And the day it used to come, I used to feel completely out of sync with life. One such day was when I was asked to read aloud, and nobody used to ridicule or laugh or pass any comment, neither teachers nor students, my friends. But one day when I, after evening assembly, jab main apne bus mein jaakar baitha window seat mein aur main bahar ki taraf dekh raha tha, and mere ko kuch nahi pata hai ki kaun bagal mein baitha hua hai, और क्या हो रहा है, क्या बातें चल रही हैं। मैं सिर्फ बाहर की तरफ देख रहा था और एक थॉट मेरे को आज भी विविडली याद है अच्छे तरीके से। एक थॉट आया कि कितना अच्छा होता अगर ये बस का फ्लोर जो है खुल जाता और मैं उससे नीचे जाता और फिर वो धरती भी खुल जाती और मैं उससे उसके नीचे जाता और मैं फिर कल से मेरे को ये दिन और ये मोमेंट्स देखने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी। उसके बाद क्या हुआ कि इट वॉज अ शैटरिंग, इट वॉज अ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ मोमेंट फॉर मी। एंड अचानक से विद इन वन मंथ हमारे घर में टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया न्यूज़पेपर आता था, तो उसमें एक आर्टिकल छपा हुआ था। फिफ्थ ग्रेड में ही मैं थोड़ा बहुत पढ़ पाया, एड था कहीं पे कि यू हैव टू गो ऑन द स्टेज मोर ऑफन टू बी एबल टू स्पीक प्रॉपरली एंड टू गेट रिड ऑफ दिस स्पीच डिसऑर्डर। तो मेरे लिए तो ये हेन एंड एग स्टोरी था कि पहले मैं ठीक होके फिर स्टेज में जाऊं कि पहले स्टेज में जाकर फिर ठीक हो। बट मेरे पास दो ही चॉइस थे, या तो ग्रो आउटसाइड योर कंफर्ट जोन एंड ग्रो, आई मीन गो आउट ऑफ योर कंफर्ट जोन एंड ग्रो, और एल्स अभी कंफर्ट जोन में रहो और जिंदगी भर इसका फेस करो। तो मैं डिसाइड किया कि आई स्टार्टेड टेकिंग पार्ट इन एलोक्यूशन ड्रामेटिक्स, I started using my energy on the sports field. तो ये सब जब होता रहा तो मैं सिर्फ एक काम करता था और मेरे को किसी टीचर ने या किसी किसी पेरेंट ने भी, उस समय के पेरेंट्स पेरेंटिंग्स भी इतने सोफिस्टिकेटेड नहीं होते थे जो आज की डेट में होते हैं, तो देश से नहीं नहीं होता है ये, सब ठीक हो जाएगा। बट आई यूज टू फील दैट यू नो दैट एग्नी पेन। तो मैं क्या करता था, मैं एक महीने पहले से इन फ्रंट ऑफ द मिरर आई यूज टू एक्ट आउट माई एलोक्यूशन स्क्रिप्ट या जो भी स्पीच स्क्रिप्ट है। आज भी याद है, वेयर देयर इज अ विल देयर इज अ वे, एंड देन देयर वाज यू नो ऑल दिस डिफरेंट पोएट्री। तो मैं इमेजिन विजुलाइज करता था, मेरे को किसी ने विजुलाइजेशन नहीं सिखाया था। आई स्टार्टेड विजुलाइजिंग दैट वन एंड हाफ मंथ्स प्रायर टू द इवेंट, एंड यू विल बी सरप्राइज टू नो दैट आई यूज टू नॉट आस्क फॉर यू नो द फर्स्ट प्राइज, आई यूज टू से फर्स्ट और सेकेंड प्राइज मिल जाए मेरे को, ठीक है। तो मेरे को फर्स्ट या सेकेंड प्राइज ही मिलता था, लेकिन प्रॉब्लम क्या हुआ कि जब मैं स्टेज से नीचे उतरता था तो सेम चीज चालू हो जाता था।
अच्छा। तो
ये सिलसिला मेरा मतलब फ्रॉम द एज ऑफ 10 टिल द एज ऑफ 18 चलता रहा, और मैं ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम स्टार्टेड टेकिंग डूइंग लॉट ऑफ ब्रीदिंग एक्सरसाइजेस।
तो मतलब स्टेज पे आप स्टैमर नहीं करते थे,
लेकिन
as soon as you get out of the stage the stammering used to come back.
Yeah, because I had tuned my subconscious mind for that event.
Okay.
विजुलाइजेशन मतलब अपने आप मैं करने लग गया उस समय, एंड इट स्टार्टेड वर्किंग फॉर मी। तो आठ साल तक मैं अपने ऊपर काम करता रहा, ब्रीदिंग प्रैक्टिस इंट्रोस्पेक्शन ये सब अपने आप करने लगा मैं। एंड बाय द टाइम आई वाज 18 आई वेंट आउट ऑफ माय होम, आई वेंट टू हॉस्टल, एंड सडनली आई नोटिस्ड वन डे दैट इट डिसअपीयर्ड।
वाओ, दैट्स ऑसम। आई थिंक दैट्स अ truly remarkable life journey of grit, determination, and what all it can accomplish for you if you are really determined to get over a certain handicap or achieve something, and how all those tools and techniques just start coming to you on their own, so without you having to kind of go to coaches and masters. I'm not denying their role, that's very important because they help you fine tune all those abilities, but at the same time, you know how much the grit of a human being can help him know himself and really achieve such a amazing feats. I'm really astounded to know about your life journey, and I really wish to salute you for what you faced and how you overcame them. And I think you're an inspiration to everybody who's listening to this show. See, I'm sure you know this is this one spark which, if gets ignited in any one of us, we can overcome the biggest of hurdles. And yes, this is a great testimony to human will, human determination. I'm truly, truly honored to have you on this platform, because what you've shared is much bigger than anything which anybody can learn. That is how the spark has to come from within you. And once you're determined, you will get there. Thank you so much. That was awesome to hear. So
thank you.
Now that's it. So where do you keep this mindfulness in this particular trial of yours? So do you connect it with being mindful
started doing the breathing practice, and I started acknowledging that there is a problem.
Hmm.
See, if you ask me what is, let me just rephrase, let me just explain what mindfulness is for the interest of the audience who is there, who will watch this before, after this recording. So before I come to the question, answering the question of your, how mindfulness applies to this situation of mine, mindfulness is nothing but being in the moment, being in the now, out of the regrets of the past and not into the anxiousness of the future. If you are walking barefoot in nature, if you are playing with your child, if you are having your bath, if you are cooking, all these are activities where you will lose yourself and be in that moment. Okay. If you're stargazing, if you are just, activities, like if you are walking your pet, all these activities need your complete attention to that activity. And definition wise, mindfulness is nothing but training your mind to manage your attention for the task at hand. It's about befriending yourself and the experiences as it is arising. It's about acknowledging and noticing your bodily sensations, your thoughts, your feelings non-judgmentally. So when all these things were happening to me, when I was so agonized, I actually understood that I have to accept this situation.
Wow.
So first of all, I unknowingly acknowledged that there is a problem. I need to root it out. Amazing. So that was the first step of mindfulness. The second step of mindfulness was when I used to be in that stage, I used to be completely there because I have tuned myself. I have tuned myself for that moment. I used to visualize how I'm receiving awards. I used to visualize how my delivery is happening, who are the judges, everything.
Did you encounter any kind of fear while doing your visualizations or while practicing or whatever you were doing? What if, if I'm unable to deliver when I go on stage? What if I make a, I embarrass myself? Ye sab man mein aata tha kyunki yahi sab sare fears hain ki jo hamara jo hum ek vision board banate hain usme kahin na kahin ek lacuna paida kar deta hai. To kya in sare jo fears the, ye jo aapke dar the kisi bhi vyakti ke jo hote hain, unko kaise aapne किनारे किया?
तो एक डिफॉल्ट एडवांटेज था मेरे को दैट आई एक्चुअली गुड दैट आई फॉट दिस स्पीच डिसऑर्डर इन माय चाइल्डहुड बिकॉज इफ आई वुड हैव ट्राइड इट इन द एडल्ट सिचुएशन इन एडल्ट लाइफ ऑफ माइन देन आई डोंट थिंक आई विल बी एबल टू फाइट इट आउट बिकॉज दोज न्यूरल पाथवेज बिकम वेरी स्ट्रांग एंड चाइल्डहुड में क्या होता है ना यू डोंट हैव मच इम्प्रिंट्स इन योर माइंड सो यू कैन एक्चुअली डू क्लियर अनक्लाउडेड विजुअलाइजेशन आई यूज्ड टू बी फियरलेस
अच्छा कभी ऐसा नहीं हुआ संदीप जी के आपके आसपास जो आपके दोस्त हैं या रिश्तेदार हैं उन्होंने कभी मजाक बनाया क्योंकि ये अक्सर जो है वो बच्चों के मन में एक कहीं ना कोई एक कुंठा बनाई देता है जिससे कि उनको एक लो सेल्फ एस्टीम हो जाता है मुझे याद है मेरा एक हम लोग जब छोटे थे तो मेरे नेबर थे उनका एक जो लड़का था वो काफी स्टैमर करता था चाहे क्या वजह थी हमें नहीं पता वो अक्सर जब भी हमारे घर आता था कभी कुछ लेने की मम्मी ने चाय की पत्ती मंगवाई है या चीनी है तो वो बेचारा स्टैमर करने लगता था और हम लोग हंसने लगते थे हम भी बच्चे थे हमें पता नहीं था और उसने भी ओवरकम किया लेकिन मुझे लगता है कि शायद उसको काफी टाइम लगा क्योंकि हम लोग को में उतनी समझ नहीं थी कि ऐसे किसी बच्चे के साथ कैसे व्यवहार करना चाहिए तो ये आप शायद लकी थे कि आपके आसपास ऐसे लोग नहीं थे या आपके पास ऐसा सपोर्टिव एनवायरनमेंट था जो कि आपको कहीं ना कहीं इंसुलेट कर देता था ऐसे लोगों से
फॉर्चुनेटली सपोर्टिव एनवायरनमेंट था और मेरे को आज तक एक भी मोमेंट याद नहीं है जहां पे दोस्त हंसे हों एक सन्नाटा हुआ करता था पूरे क्लास में एंड दैट यूज टू बाइट मी दैट चिलिंग deafening silence
okay
Teacher also never used to approach me on that topic. If anybody is watching this, you know, I'm much grateful to those teachers who never actually came and interfered with my the way I'm handling it. And every day I used to work on it, actually.
तो इसकी वजह से क्या आपने देखा कि आपके जो जिंदगी का ग्राफ है वो स्टेडिली ऊपर ही जा रहा है, क्योंकि आपने एक बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज जो है वो ओवरकम कर लिया अपने विजुलाइजेशन से, अपने डिटर्मिनेशन से कि मुझे इसको करना है. फिर क्या कभी ऐसा जिंदगी में हुआ कि फिर ऐसा ही कोई बहुत ही इनसर्माउंटेबल और डिफिकल्ट कोई चुनौती आपके सामने आई और फिर आपको लगा कि नहीं, जो मैंने जो सीखा है अब वो और काम नहीं आ रहा, मुझे अब कुछ और, एक कोई वॉल है और मुझे आगे जाना पड़ेगा, तो ऐसी सिचुएशन में फिर आपने क्या किया, वो कैसी प्रॉब्लम थी?
तो राइट, एक्चुअली वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन. होता क्या है कि हमारे लाइफ किसी तरीके से लिखा रहता है एंड वी गेट कंडीशनड बाय आवर अपब्रिंगिंग, पेरेंट्स, टीचर्स, पीयर्स, मीडिया, नेबर्स, एंड वी गेट कंडीशन एंड देन वी लूज आवर कोर, अपने अंदर जो कोर वैल्यूज हैं, जो एक्सपीरियंसेस हैं, जो की स्ट्रेंथ्स हैं, तो उस सभी को छोड़कर आई ऑल्सो रैन द रैट रेस. उसके बाद हायर एजुकेशन किया, आई स्टडी फ्रॉम BHU, बनारस हिंदू यूनिवर्सिटी, एंड देन आई डिड माई MBA फ्रॉम सिम्बायोसिस. सो व्हेन आई वाज MBA करने के बाद आई कंप्लीटली केम आउट ऑफ दिस मोड, lost this world completely, and same earning promotion, all those things were happening, and 10 saal ke baad mere ko, I came back from my tour. I was in IBM then, and I came back from my tour from Latin America, Argentina, Mexico, Brazil. Maine training di thi apne कॉलीग्स को, बिकॉज जॉब रोटेशन होता है वहां पे, IBM में जॉब रोटेशन होता है, सो पीपल ज्वाइन फ्रॉम डिफरेंट फंक्शंस इनटू मार्केटिंग. तो मैं मार्केटिंग सेंटर ऑफ एक्सेलेंस IBM में था, तो हमारे को ट्रेनिंग देना था अपने न्यू कॉलीग्स को. आई ट्रेंड 100 पीपल एंड केम बैक एंड आई वॉज आस्किंग माई सेल्फ, इट वॉज सेप्टेम्बर 2011, एंड आई वॉज आस्किंग माई सेल्फ कि संदीप, यू वॉन्टेड टू वर्क फॉर अ मल्टीनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन ए मल्टी कल्चरल एनवायरमेंट and you are doing well, aur hamara training ka bhi rating kafi 4.5 se upar aaya out of 5, are you really happy? So to my surprise the answer came, no, this is not the life that I want to have. And that was 2011, and it took me 3 years, and that is when all these teachers, mentors, workshops, retreats, programs, lot of readings, and I would recommend, and you know, with my I'll humbly suggest all the audience today, if you are stuck in any of this kind of situation where you are on a quest of your life, please attend workshops, webinars, seminars, write book, you know, choose the models that you know, the people whom you want to model. Don't get motivated, but draw inspiration from there and try to figure out what is you know, matching with you. So that is what I started doing for 3 years, and that is when I understood that I have to connect back to who I was. Because you asked me, you gave me a comment that, you know, it will be an inspiration for you know, other people for what you have achieved. But actually, mere andar bachpan mein hi tha when I overcame this, that I would like to do something for people who don't have confidence, who operate from the space of fear, from the space of self-doubt, disbelief. Okay, तो उनके लिए कुछ करना था, but after MBA everything got clouded and मैं भूल चुका था. That is when you know destiny you know strikes at you, and destiny, nature, universe, जो भी बोल दो, they keep working on you and keep reminding you through all possible ways. In a light mode, in a tough mode, and that is when I started hopping jobs. Lot of, you know, I tried one more role in IBM, then I moved from IBM to a different company, but kahin pe bhi I was not able to feel that kind of peace what I was seeking. That is when I realized that I need to go back and start doing things which I used to do, and I resumed my practice.
ग्रेट. अच्छा संदीप जी, आप मुझे बताएंगे कि आपसे आपके वर्कशॉप में जो लोग आते हैं वो क्या उम्मीद लेकर के आते हैं, और आपके वर्कशॉप को करने के बाद, आपके कोर्सेज को करने के बाद उनके अंदर क्या चेंजेस आते हैं, और फिर आपने कभी देखा है कि अपनी जिंदगी में वो जहां पे थे पॉइंट ए से, क्या वो ए बी सी या कहीं और पहुंचे कि नहीं, तो कैन यू जस्ट गिव अ ग्लिम्प्स इनटू दिस मॉड्यूल ऑफ योर वर्कशॉप, बिकॉज आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल ओवर हियर आर देयर टू नो व्हाट दे कैन एक्सपेक्ट इन दिस वर्कशॉप ऑफ योर्स.
आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर समथिंग. सबसे पहला तो मैं दिखा दूं कि दिस इज व्हाट आई टीच पीपल. ओके, दिस इज व्हाट इज द सेल्फ मास्टरी कोड. And in this, what all are included is dissolve alpha affirmation, manifestation secrets, and then mindfulness, miracles, guided mindfulness, forgiveness track, alpha affirmation, guided mindfulness practice tracks, and then self-discovery guide and a weekly inner circle calls that we keep nurturing. But iske alawe, what I wanted to share with you is this. This is what people say. And by the way, self-mastery code has been endorsed by John Maton, who is 3 times in a row number one executive leadership coach of the world. And this is what he had to say, because he also operates from the soul and the core point of view, and I also keep that in the center. So he actually resonated, and we are both are in personal touch with each other. So coming back to what people say, you know, Rahul Singh is one of my client. He says, amazing program, well thought and great vision to put to create self-mastery code. This program is really helping me every day inch towards self-mastery. Vidya Lakshmi says, it's absolutely absolute addiction. I couldn't stop myself from getting into day two on day one itself. Well balanced, and it brings a change from the root level. And that is what we try. We try to, you know, go to the source of the suffering, the source of what is the source of our unhappiness. And so, that is self-awareness. Yeah.
Okay. So let me come back to the, to the statement that you just made, that what is the source of unhappiness? So what you've actually found mostly is a source of unhappiness in people's life when they try to go back to their core essence, which you say that it's what you endeavor to do in most of the workshops.
Yeah.
So what is it that eventually mostly you find? What is lying there?
Yes, let me tell you. So the source of unhappiness is actually, we are stuck in the past, or we are anxious about the future. What if this wouldn't have happened in my life? What if I never work in the corporate world? What if I'm able to take this course to a global audience? I'm far in the future. Okay. So every day, every time, every moment, we are in the anxiousness of the future, or in the regret of the past, we are actually not living in the moment. And that is the source of the misery, of misery. And that is where mindfulness creates the foundation stone. Okay. The foundation stone of mindfulness comes in, and over that, we actually help people to let go, forgive others, at the same time themselves. So once you have created that, you know, let me show you that through a slide. Let me just show you that. That will be helpful. I have something. Yeah, this one. Yes. So we all 7.3 billion people on this planet, we all need success, happiness, and peace, right? We all need, so this is, let me start here. We all need success, happiness, and peace. Where does those success, happiness, and peace comes from? It comes from the action that we take. The action comes from the choices that we are able to see for ourselves, time to time, moment to moment. The choices come from the habit that we have formed over a period of, you know, years, decades. The habits come from the attitude that we have developed within ourselves, and the attitude comes from the belief system that we have created within ourselves. Where does this belief system come from? These belief systems come from the attention, mindfulness, self-awareness, and that is the source of everything. So if you are able to be mindful, attentive in the present moment, key, right now I have this opportunity, okay, of making the best of my talk show right now with Life Positive team, with you, Shivi, so that I can reach out and impact the world in the best possible way. If at this moment sitting here, if I start thinking about how nice it would be if this video becomes viral, okay, then I have lost the connection with you. I've lost the connection with the question. I've lost the connection with this moment. And that is when, you know, this belief system, attitude, habits, all that we have done goes for a toss. I mean, it starts acting against us. And this success, happiness, and peace will be elusive. So that's why I say success always starts from self-awareness and attention.
But mostly, you know, whatever you're talking about, things that either keep us in the past or in the anxiety of the future are mostly emotion based. And it's very difficult to get rid of emotions which have a negative residue in our mind, because the emotion has an energy of its own. And I think it can be quite an exercise to get rid of those emotions.
Yes.
For women or for men, anything abusive has happened in somebody's life, perhaps in childhood, which is often in the case. And it's very difficult for people to get over those memories that haunt them. And we don't have many people who will understand or empathize.
Right.
So then will just, you know, this mindfulness be able to kind of get, would it be enough for them to kind of just keep it on the back burner and focus on what they have before them, unless and until they kind of root out that problem from its origin?
So I would like to answer this question from multiple perspectives. I would like to touch upon the concept of self-image. I would like to touch upon the practice of the practice, the actual daily practice of mindfulness, like brushing the teeth. And then how it creates an environment within our mind so that we are able to take advantage of that self-image recreation. Okay. So first of all, let me explain for the interest of the audience that self-image, see, we are not what we are looking at ourselves in the mirror every day. We are not our reflection. Okay. We are what we think what we are, which means that our mind has already made something. There is a deep sense of psyche that Sandeep knows that this is what Sandeep is. It's not my reflection in the mirror that I'm seeing. That is not defining me. So that self-image needs to be reprogrammed, retuned, reworked on. And if I ask you that, you know, there are a lot of programs like anger management, conflict management, leadership development, all these programs happen. If there is such program on changing the self-image, next day, if people want to change their self-image, they will not be able to do it until and unless there is a self-awareness foundation which is created through mindfulness practice regularly, so that he or she will be able to pinpoint when I'm going wrong in my self-image. When there is a moment to be on the stage, I say, no, not me. No, I'm not comfortable. I don't want to do it today, because there's something suddenly in fraction of seconds, something has happened. That self-image has that person inside my head is telling me, Sandeep, you are not good enough. You have not done this before. You have failed before. So don't take this up. Don't take the risk. Okay. So that self-image has to be changed through self-awareness, which should be a practice. When we use this mindfulness as a daily practice, like brushing the teeth, and a lot of my tribe members are there on the call. I mean, on this session, I can see their names. So Jobby, Vidyalakshmi, let me see. So a lot of them, Vishaka, Megha, yes. She has joined from US. So so self-awareness is important to be able to intervene the self-image, which is not serving you. Just knowing that this self-image is not serving me, we will start self-beating. We will start self-doubting. and will not work towards it. We'll try to be in the comfort zone, and the word that you used in the beginning, procrastination. आज नहीं कल करते हैं, बाद में देखते हैं. Favorable हो जाएगा situation तो कर लेंगे. Okay, that will not happen. You become, you know, if you ask me the takeaways of mindfulness, profound takeaways, we become fearless. We become so clear that we are fearless in life. Fearless as a peaceful warrior, not like a, you know, like not like a fighting warrior, but you know, fearless warrior and a peaceful warrior and a fearless person that we become because of the clarity that we get. So self-awareness is a practice which is helpful. And as a concept, it goes and impacts letting go, you know, within us. We start forgiving ourselves for what I have not been able to do or what happened through me in the past, because past is over. Future has not come.
So what is the role of spiritual practices in this entire module? Because forgiveness is very much you know, related to that realm of life. It is said that you can decide to forget. But you cannot forgive. Forgiveness happens only when you are kind of take recourse to a power which is higher than you. Yes. So do you also take people on the path of spirituality, which is very much connected with self-discovery and knowing yourself? Mindfulness is also about that. So eventually people stumble on this path and on their path to self-discovery.
Yeah, actually I do not pronounce it like that in my course. But people understand it that, you know, he's subtly taking it through, taking us through that journey. Okay. Again, spirituality has been interpreted and understood in different dimensions and in different perspectives. For me, I have kept it very simple, and all my community members, tribe members, they know how I look at spirituality. Spirituality is being myself, not wearing a mask. If I'm being the same here, what I am being with my, you know, with my subordinate or with my help at home or with the security person in my building, okay, if I am being the same way and I don't have to portray anything, this is something that, you know, that was having a huge load on me when I was in the corporate world. Okay, and my I understood that for me, the core values were freedom, authenticity, and personal growth. And the second one is authenticity. I was not able to be authentic. Okay. For me, that was hammering me every day. Okay. So coming back to the question, spirituality is being, being the core that I am. If I'm able to, make the people connect with their core values, who they really are. It is actually a deep, profound exercise. There are a lot of ebbs and flows and, you know, troughs and crests and troughs, in that. But people who know my way of working approach, they know that, you know, sometimes I switch between being a coach and being a mentor. Okay. So I personalize it with intuition. So I don't know, I have not, you know, shared with you, but I developed intuition before I came into mindfulness. And because from my childhood, I used to be, so I used to be into that mindful, you know, breathing and all those understanding of energy concept was already there. And when I started doing mindfulness, then everything came together. And now in my life coaching, I actually understand how much is the bandwidth of this person in terms of spirituality, that question that you're asking. I cannot just put them into that fire straight away. So I take time, understand the person, understand their energy, and then slowly make him dip. And, you know, there are transformations like, you know, people who have come to me in mid-May asking about, I cannot live without this person. The same person is calling me today. Also, I had a session with that person saying that, you know, I am fulfilled in myself right now. I don't care about whether the person comes back or not. Whether if he comes back, fine. If he does not, you know, I am doing well. I am happy. Thank you so much, Sandeep ji.
So that gap, that hole, that gap in the soul gets filled because of these practices, and they feel less dependent on others for their needs.
Yeah. Great. So I don't call it spirituality. I don't even use that word. But in my intro, I say that, you know, in a spiritual environment, all this psychotherapy, mindfulness, all this is layered together in a spiritual environment.
So you do feel that there are people who are like more receptive to these things, and there are people who kind of want to stay away from this whole stuff. They simply want their problems to get resolved.
Yeah.
And what is the fear when, you know, because you say that you are kind of very cautious with regard to using the term called spirituality, because it might put a few people off, and they are resistant to this very idea.
Right.
So whereas, like, kind of in my and your experience, it can be the most fulfilling thing you can ever experience, because it kind of there's no area of life which stays untouched, because if once you enter it, whereas there are people, you say, are like wary of this term. So what do you think is the difference between those who kind of go for it, like duck takes to water, and the others who are wary of it, and why they are?
Biological reason is that, you know, the same thing I'll touch upon is, like, we operate from the left side of the brain. We are conditioned to run the race. Okay. We are competing with others. We feel our validation will come from the likes. Our validation will come from the people saying yes to me. Our validation will come from how many upvotes, or how many likes, or how many followers I have. Okay, so from that point of view, people start looking at their life, and that is when it goes off the track. But there are some people who work from the right side of the brain, and that's what I have noticed in my sessions. People, if I talk about the horizontal and the vertical, okay, the people, the horizontal that I have seen, or jo a common trait mein sabhi mein dekhta hun ki, they look for something more and deep in their life. They come to me. They don't know what is missing. They don't know what is that depth. Us depth mein jane se kya milega? But I sense that from their questions. So that is one thing that I see the common thing. And the teachers, spiritual, people on the spiritual quest, teachers, academicians, creative people, writers, artists, and then there's one more segment which actually comes to me, and that is people who are in the midlife
crisis
transformation. Just keeping that crisis word away, midlife transformation. Midlife is the time when, and that is where I cannot talk to them about spirituality. They'll say, ye kahan, matlab mere ko apna answer chahiye, as you rightly said, that they want solution to their problem. And the typical question of these people are, I am fed up of my corporate job. I worked for 15, 20, 20 years now. They're typically of the age group of 37 to 45 kind of age group. I have earned, my children are grown up now. I am lost. I have made money. I have, I have land, I have property, I have this and that, everything is, but I'm not happy. Then I remind them, one of the top five regrets of the world, of the dying, in the world of the dying people is, I wish I lived a life true to myself, not the one what others expected of me. Do you want to die with this regret? I ask them, do you want to die with this regret? And that is where the conversation starts. And then I steer them towards, why don't you take a stock of what are your, again, the same three things. What are your core values? What are your experiences, good and bitter? How do you connect looking backwards, looking back? Okay. And what are your key strengths? So there are a lot of exercises and, frameworks that we follow. Based on that, they derive what their core values are, and then they start seeing, okay, fine, then I can do this as a next phase of my life, so that, you know, I don't get burnt out completely.
तो कभी आपने ऐसा देखा है कि उनको रिग्रेट होता है कि अरे हमने तो अपने जीवन के बहुत सारे कीमती वर्ष जो है वो काम करने में गुजार दिए जो मैं कभी करना ही नहीं चाहता था, ऐसा आपने कभी देखा है कि ऐसा होता है? और फिर उनका एक सवाल होता है कि अब मैं आगे क्या करूं? और क्योंकि देखिए भले ही अब कुछ भी कहूँ, जो नोन होता है उसमें एक किस्म की सेफ्टी तो होती ही है, बिल्कुल अननोन टेरिटरी में आप एकदम, मतलब अननोन भले ना कहूँ लेकिन एक नई टेरिटरी में आप जंप करते हैं, जब आप अपनी लाइफ को रिक्रिएट करने चलते हैं तो उसमें बहुत सारे रिस्क होते हैं। हम देखते हैं कि बहुत से लोगों ने कॉर्पोरेट जॉब छोड़ करके ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग शुरू कर दी क्योंकि उनको लगा कि वो उनका सोल कॉल है, या कुछ इस तरह की जैसे कोचिंग भी शुरू करी या इस तरह की हीलिंग के काम में आगे, बहुत से लोग ऐसा करते हैं, लेकिन उसमें वो अपने साथ अपने तरह के स्ट्रेसेस भी लेकर के आता है। ये कोई जरूरी नहीं है कि आपने कर लिया तो बड़े खुश हो रहे हैं आप, तो उस टाइम पे भी तो सेल्फ डाउट आता होगा, तो फिर माइंडफुलनेस और सेल्फ मास्टरी उस ऐसे टाइम पे कैसे मदद करती
है? यस, वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन, आई मिस्ड वन पॉइंट, एंड दिस माय क्लाइंट एक्चुअली पॉइंटेड आउट टू मी दैट योर मेथड दैट यू फॉलो इज द सेम एज लोगोथेरेपी। इफ यू गूगल लोगोथेरेपी, लोगोथेरेपी इज अ थेरेपी व्हिच इन 1940s विक्टर फ्रैंकल, हु रोट द बुक मैन्स सर्च फॉर मीनिंग, he was a holocaust survivor in the nazi concentration camp, so wahan pe he lived till his 90s, but all his near and dear ones were killed right in front of him, father, mother, brother, sister, wife, all of them I think were killed in front of him, wife ka pata nahi but all other family members, so he lived through that ordeal just because he wanted to reach out to the world that if you have a meaning in your life, then you can go through anything, almost anything. And one of his famous quote is, those who have a why to live can bear almost any how, anyhow nahi, anyhow, how, can bear any how, matlab kaise jeena hai wo pata laga lenge agar sirf unko wo pata chale ki क्या उनका मीनिंग क्या है लाइफ का। एंड द सेम थिंग मैं भी अपने क्लाइंट्स के साथ करता हूं कि उनके साथ वो रेजोनेट होना चाहिए। मैं उनको कोई ऐसे फील्ड में, ऐसे वर्ल्ड में नहीं उनको जंप करने बोल देता हूं कि विच इज देयर इनसाइड देम। आई टेक केयर दैट द प्लेस वेयर दे आर गोइंग नेक्स्ट इज एग्जैक्टली व्हाट इट इज देयर इनसाइड हिम और हर। So that I make sure.
तो मतलब कहीं ना कहीं वो रोड मैप उनके अंदर ऑलरेडी फिक्स्ड है, वो बस उन्हें दिख नहीं रहा, और एक बार अगर वो रोड मैप दिखने लग जाए तो फिर उनको कोई भी प्रॉब्लम हो उससे डरते नहीं है।
Exactly.
और बस उतनी सी बात है, तो यानी कि हम सभी के अंदर वो रोड मैप कहीं ना कहीं एग्जिस्ट करता है हमारी लाइफ जर्नी को लेकर के।
उसको इस तरह से भी समझ सकते हैं कि एक मिरर है जिसके ऊपर एक मड लगा हुआ है, एक मतलब दोनों साइड से मतलब गंदा एक मिरर है जो वो देख नहीं पा रहे हैं। रोज वहां जाते हैं लेकिन चूंकि वो गंदा है वो देख नहीं पा रहे हैं कि मेरी शक्ल कैसे दिख रही है, मैं कैसा दिख रहा हूँ। तो मेरा काम सिर्फ नहीं रहता है वहां से मड हटा देता हूँ, वो गंदगी जो है वो डस्ट हटा देता हूँ वहां से, और अपने आप को देख लो।
अच्छा, आई विल आस्क यू वन लास्ट क्वेश्चंस बिफोर वी ओपन द सेशन फॉर क्वेश्चंस।
श्योर।
संदीप जी, बस मुझे ये बताइए कि आपका जो अभी तक जो बहुत से लोगों को आपने कोच किया है, सबसे बड़ा ऐसा कौन सा कोई ऐसा आपके पास उदाहरण है जो आपका ही कहते ना क्लाइंट रहा हो जिसकी लाइफ में आपने पैराडाइम शिफ्ट्स देखे, यू सॉ पैराडाइम शिफ्ट्स एंड यू नो हिज लाइफ चेंजिंग लिटरली 360 डिग्रीज आफ्टर ही अंडरवेंट योर कोचिंग, वो ऐसा कुछ एग्जाम्पल आप हमारे ऑडियंस को प्लीज दीजिए।
यस, इनफैक्ट मैं पहले बोलूंगा और मैं वीडियो दिखाऊंगा उसके बाद, पहले बताता हूं उनके बारे में। हाँ, पहले मैं बताता हूं उनके बारे में। शी हैज अलाउड मी, शी हैज परमिटेड मी, सो शी हैज शी हैड कम टू मी, शी वर्क्स इन मल्टीनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और अच्छे अच्छे पोजीशन में, अच्छे रोल में, एंड वो सीए है, ठीक है, काम कर रही थी, बट शी हैड सम इमोशनल वेलबींग इश्यूज, That is when she came in touch with me. And from there on, जब मैं उनको कोच और मेंटोर करने लगा, सो उसके बाद ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऐसा हुआ कि नाउ शी इज वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग एंड क्लियर इन हर लाइफ. एंड अभी जॉब भी जाता है तो फर्क नहीं पड़ता, शी टेक्स अ ब्रेक ऑल्सो, बिकॉज यू नो वन ऑफ माई फेवरेट कोट इज स्लो डाउन टू स्पीड अप. मैं इसके ऊपर काफी आर्टिकल्स भी लिखा हूँ इन ग्लोबल मैगजीन्स, स्लो डाउन टू स्पीड अप. तो शी ऑल्सो बिलीव दैट नाउ. So she has adopted lot of my things, and when actually she was recording her testimonial and jab wo mere ko bheji to mere ko laga ki I was able to, you know, give all this to her, and she's actually telling it back to me that what I stand for. I would like your viewers and you all to listen to that. Let me actually dekhta hu ek second. This one. देख पा रहे हैं
जी?
ओके, सो लेट मी प्ले दिस साउंड. आई होप द साउंड वर्क्स.
हाय, आई एम हेमा एंड आई एम अ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट बाय प्रोफेशन एंड आई एम फ्रॉम बैंगलोर. आई मेट संदीप in my quest to finding out more about myself, to find more peace within myself. Until for a lot of my days when I was a really young girl, I didn't really understand what exactly people meant by we need more peace. We need more peace in mind. We need more peace in life. I thought, you know, at that point in time, I was happy with what things as they were, because perhaps then we saw things as they were. We were not bothered about the future or the past. We just present in the present moment and didn't really understand what the adults were talking about when they said, we are looking for mental peace. Until I became an adult myself. So I, instead of focusing on the present moment, a lot many times I was focused on the past and then the fears of future. And between the both, I was losing out on the moment of today. And I never realized that until I met Sandeep, who actually made me, initially it was very, let me just go back a little bit. Initially, I was a little skeptic because I thought I was comfortable in my zone, always thinking about the future. Yeah, I thought that's the way it was supposed to be. But then when I met Sandeep, I realized that, you know, the change what happened in my mind was perhaps because of the conditioning that's happened throughout the years, which we never realize. And what he did was provide me with that guidance. Sometimes all of us need that. We think, you know, this, you know, spending time on mind or spending time for finding out what why we are really here is actually a waste of time, that, you know, it's a waste of resources. But that is actually one of the resources you need to invest in, because until your mind is strong, until your belief in yourself is strong, everything just is like a house of falling cards, you know, because it's just waiting for one card to fall and everything just collapses. And then you're just looking out and figuring out, oh, maybe I made my priorities, set my priorities wrongly. So I'm hugely grateful that I think it was destiny that I met Sandeep. I'm hugely grateful for the opportunity that I got and for the holistic coaching that he provided, which I don't think you find everywhere, because he's just not talking about problem and just leaving you to sort it out by yourself. But what he really does is he holds your hand, gives you tools so that you're actually able to turn your life around and become the kid that you used to be, where you're focused in the present moment, where you're focused on what you're doing right now, and not letting the fears of the past experiences or the future experiences that are not yet happened to actually govern the majority part of your life. And I think this is an investment which should be actually monetary for everybody. But unfortunately, even now, there's a lot of lack of awareness. And I really hope and I really wish that Sandeep transcends boundaries and is able to help so many lives like he's done with mine. And I can't thank him enough for it.
Wow, that was really very inspiring. That was great listening to her. Now, I would like all the participants, especially the listeners of the show, if they have any questions, they can ask them. They can unmute themselves.
Yes.
I'm allowing everybody to unmute themselves. And if you have any questions you want to ask from Sandeep, please do. This is your moment.
Oh, you're not able to hear me?
Okay. Yes. We were unable to hear you.
Please go ahead.
Any questions from anybody?
Ask in voice or you can type. Yeah, Rishi, you can unmute yourself and ask.
You can unmute yourself and ask the question.
Yeah, am I audible?
Yes, Rishi.
So I would like to understand, is there any difference between living mindfulness or just between mindfulness and contemplation? And if it is different, how different they are, how it works in evolving ourselves in daily life.
Yes. I'll give you example of that. Okay. From my life, because I had done contemplation when I had that speech disorder. Now both are important, but you have to understand the perspective when what is important. So to acknowledge the problem, we have to do contemplation. We have to look back, see the events, how it is happening. We have to project, extrapolate the events. Ki agar aise hi chalta raha, toh where it will lead me to. So those are contemplation. But mindfulness is about, if I can do mindfulness while eating, I can do mindfulness as I'm talking to you, Rishi, right now. How I'm doing that? I'm just feeling, my presence over this chair, and I can just feel my breath, the taste on my tongue, and what I am seeing, I am 100% there. So this is mindfulness. Ki abhi aap kisi cheez ke bare soch nahi rahe ho. Contemplation is that there is something you have prioritized to ponder upon, to discern, that discerning, okay, decision. And after pondering, you will make some decision. But you will not be able to contemplate and discern well if you are not mindful. Because you will have biases playing there. You will have clouded thoughts there. You will have prejudices and biases. So both are equally important.
Yeah.
Thank you. Very good question. Yeah. Very good question.
Thank you.
And any other question from anybody? We have a lot of listeners right now with us.
Vidya has a lot of questions. Vidya?
Vidya Lakshmi has something to ask.
Yes, Vidya Lakshmi, please ask your question.
Unmute yourself. Vidya, go ahead.
Yes.
Sandeep ji, we have. We cannot hear you, Sandeep ji. Please unmute yourself.
Yeah, I unmuted myself. Vidya, go ahead.
Yeah. Okay. So now when we are talking about mindfulness, it's like, my question is that now it's like a child wandering continuously, mm-hmm. The child is restless, just like a mind is restless. Okay.
Yes. Yes.
So the person who has some knowledge about it, okay, ki mujhe kuch ho raha hai. So that person can sit and settle for the mindfulness. Hmm. What about the person who is absolutely not aware about him? So he'll be like, how do you first step is like to make him sit.
Hmm.
To 5 minutes, 10 minutes better. So how do we start to make him to sit?
A classic case are today's children.
Exactly.
Today's children.
Children.
Classic case. How do you make them understand? So children ka to abhi rakhte side mein.
But I'm talking about, I'm also relating.
Yeah.
Adults may be.
Yeah.
See, every day, in everyday course, everybody is like, the day starts, they're thinking about, okay, I have to go to work. I have to do this. I have to do that. The day starts with all those things.
Plans.
Okay. Yeah. The conflicts inside is happening. There will be so many conflicts that is happening inside the mind. But how do we make the person to thoda break though, or you sit, thoda sa settle ho ja.
You spoke the right word there, break though. Slow down to speed up. That is what I keep telling people. Ki see, I give them analogy of bow and arrow. Okay. First, I'll explain through an analogy and then I'll come to the actual, you know, answer. The arrow has to go back on the bow string. You have to stretch it, point it to the target and keep it holding there so that it gains momentum. And then you release it and it goes and hits the target. Second example is, could be about highway hypnotism. If you are going at a breakneck speed, you are driving, you are not mindful about the side view, peripheral view. You're just looking and ahead and you are zooming ahead. Suddenly something comes up, what happens? So we have to slow down to be able to see the side peripheral view. We have to slow down to actually point the arrow in the right direction. Just shooting an arrow is not important. So what I tell to these people, first of all, little bit of strictness is required by a coach or a mentor to show them. What I do is I show them what you will be 10 years down the line if you continue in the same trajectory. Okay. If you show that life to them, that is the same thing which I did to myself. At the age of 10, I thought, if I am continuing like this, then where will I go? What will I do in my life? So you have to do that and then empower them, bring them back and say that, no, not everything is lost. Okay. You still have the power of the presence, of the present. And you can work from now on. People die without a purpose and you are living here. There are, you know, people say they are victim of circumstances. There is a differently abled person who is a motivational speaker of the world, Nick Vujicic, okay, in Australia. And there are differently abled people here in the streets of, in any country, they will beg. Okay, the situation, the circumstance has not made them what they are doing. It is the stories that they tell to themselves. So I help them to change the story in their head. That is what you have to do.
Great.
Perfect.
Lovely. So any more questions? Because I think we are like about to now close this session. This one last question we can still take. Any more questions? No questions. Okay, so I hope that you will all reserve your questions for the 5th of September when you attend Mr. Sandeep's program, Self-Mastery Through Mindfulness, because there the actual work will happen. There you will be given the tools and the techniques through which you can create a new you.
Yes.
So please register for that program. The link will be given in the description box. And also to all the viewers of YouTube, please like, share, comment, and subscribe to the Life Positive Show. We will be regularly bringing.
I have I have a small gift for your viewers in Zoom, or maybe you can use that in the description of your YouTube also. Let me just share a link. They can actually get their personalized mindfulness score. Shall I give that? Shall I
share
that?
Yeah, please do. Please go ahead. Please go ahead.
And let me share that link. A personalized mindfulness score they will get. So I will share it with you so that you can post it in YouTube also or wherever. So this is the link. You can open a new tab using this link. And you can answer 15 questions for yourself.
Great.
And you will get a detailed report on 5 different areas of mindfulness.
That's lovely. I think that's a great unmissable opportunity for all of you to find out our score and where we stand on the spectrum of self-knowledge and where we are limiting ourselves. Great. Please, the link is there in the description box as well as a link to the registration of the event on 5th of September. Please do join in, and this will also be given in the description box of the YouTube channel. So please make note of all these things. So thank you, everybody. Thank you, all the viewers. And thanks a lot, Mr. Sandeep Pandit, for being on the show tonight and helping so many people through your own lived experience of life. You're truly an inspiration, and anybody who feels that the circumstances have tied them down and they cannot overcome them, I'm sure this talk will motivate you to look at your life from a completely different point of view. Thank you so much, everybody.
It was my pleasure, Shiviji, and to the entire Life Positive team. and to people who I can impact through whatever you know minimal ways that we have tried to do today.
Mm-hmm.
And thank you for having me on the show.
Thank you once again. Please. And please do like, comment, share and subscribe and share the word about the online retreat, which will be organized on 4th and 5th. And on 5th is a talk by, the workshop by Mr. Sandeep Pandit. Please make the best use of this opportunity. And thank you so much for being there. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Sandeep Ji.
Thank you.
Thank you.